You've been watching special coverage of the crisis in Syria. President Obama has just finished addressing the nation. He says he's asked Congress to postpone a vote that would authorize the U.S. military to carry out a strike in Syria. That's because he wants to pursue a possible diplomatic solution.
Yeah, however, the president says the U.S. must act in some way to prevent the future use of chemical weapons like the one that he says Syria's government used to kill more than 1,000 of its own civilians.
After careful deliberation, I determined that it is in the national security interests of the United States to respond to the Assad regime's use of chemical weapons through a targeted military strike. The purpose of this strike would be to deter Assad from using chemical weapons, to degrade his regime's ability to use them, and to make clear to the world that we will not tolerate their use. That's my judgment as Commander-in-Chief.
President wrapping up his comments just about a minute and a half ago. Let's bring in Republican analyst Kevin Eckery, also Democratic strategist Roger Salazar, both joining us tonight. They're going to give us a closer look at what the president said. And Kevin, I guess I'll start with you. And the comments tonight says that they're not doing anything yet.
Yeah, I'm sitting here, and frankly, I'm doing kind of a slow burn about the speech. And first of all, you need to realize I'm one of those people who's wired to say politics stops at the water's edge. So I don't think, and Roger may agree with me as well, this isn't so much a Democrat-Republican thing as a I can't believe this is what you're doing thing. Kids don't care if they're killed by high explosives or by poison gas. And what's going to be happening here is that for the 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months, however long this very successful Russian gambit is drawn out, there are going to be kids killed with mortar shells and bombs and rockets and small arms fire, and this does nothing for the ground truth and everything for proving that Vladimir Putin may be the best poker player in the world.
Well, Roger, let me ask you, I mean, does this so-called Russian solution, does it in some way diminish what the president wants to do?
No, I don't think so. Again, I think it's important to note that this isn't the president who rushes to war. This is the guy who, you know, who won the Nobel Peace Prize, and he's going to be want to look for a peaceful solution to this. And there's no question that something's got to be done here. But I think, you know, no matter what the is happening here with this Russian solution here, there has to be a serious one. There can't be any tricks about it. It can't be a ruse. They've got to be very, very serious about this. Otherwise, it's not going to work. And again, I think it's also important to note that the only reason that the Syrians came to the table was because of the credible threat by the president to attack Syria, and so you know, he deserves some credit for that at least.
Yeah, but these weapons exist for one reason, and that was to be a strategic deterrent for Israel's nuclear force. They're only designed to really go after the Israelis, and the fact wasn't really intended to be used, they've now used it's a vicious, it's horrible, but now the entire world is talking about, you know, something other than solving the civil war, and it is an exceptionally bold misdirection. And I have to, you know, give Assad and Putin credit for coming up with it, but it puts the Americans in a bad way.
I do want to throw in here, I mean, we know that more than half of Americans are against a strike. So what do you guys think came out of this speech that will convince Americans that this is the right direction to go? Roger, let's start with you.
Well, I think what the Americans are seeing is that the president is being very thoughtful about this, very deliberate about this, and again, does not want to put Americans in harm's way, but does want to make the point very clearly that we've got to do something about this situation. You know, how many people are going to have to die before we sort of before we get involved in this thing? And so he doesn't want to necessarily be a shoot first type of president. He's not a cowboy like the previous president was. He wants to be very thoughtful, and if there's a diplomatic solution, if there's a peaceful way for us to resolve this issue, get rid of the chemical weapons, stop the killing in the civil war there, then we ought to explore it at least, and at least give it an opportunity to see what we can do about it.
All right, Roger Salazar with Kevin Eckery giving both sides of the issue here after the president addressed the nation tonight on the issue of Syria. Thanks, guys.
And we'll, of course, continue to follow this through the night. You can stay with KCRA3 with our continuing coverage of the crisis in Syria. We will have much more reaction to the president's speech tonight on our late news at 10 and 11, and you'll also find a lot of information online. We've put the full speech, or we will be putting that up on KCRA.com, and you'll get more information on our mobile app as well.